So let's see, this is another toilet. Mm-hmm. Are you telling me that people are going to the toilet and then it goes down like that?
Well, in Kenya, he's Kenyan, but he stays and resides in Tanzania. And him is as a Kenyan, I think he's the best person for us to start with.
Do you think this was a first class train? You see, it has a door, and then inside here, a cabin. What is this? You see how it has eaten life, like it has been used and used and used. And we have, this looks new.
Kenya, well, in Kenya, he's Kenyan, but he stays and resides in Tanzania. And him is as a Kenyan, I think he's the best person for us to start with and for us to know what he thinks of Tanzania. So nitakuuliza maswali kidogo, kusema, tuambie unafikiria nini kuhusu wa Tanzania, vile wako kama watu. Ni sawa? Okay. So I'm going to ask him how he thinks of Tanzanians because he's Kenyan, but he stays in Tanzania. So we tunaweza anza. Sawa. So unaweza tuambie jina lako ama uko comfortable?
Naweza kuambia.
Tuambie.
Mimi naitwa George Mwita.
Aha. Kutoka wapi?
Kutoka Kenya.
Kenya wapi?
Ntimaru. Ntimaru.
He's Kenyan and he stays in Tanzania. He's from a place called Ntimaru. So kama wewe kama Mkenya na unakaa Tanzania, unafikiria je kuhusu Watanzania kama watu?
Watanzania watu wazuri sana.
Aha.
Sijawahi kuona watu wazuri ambao wana ubaguzi.
Aha.
Wanachukulia kila mtu kama ndugu.
Ndugu.
Na wana ile ukabila.
Yeah.
Ukabila ni mengi, 120.
Aha.
Na 8.
Aha.
Hawaangalii hiyo.
Hawana ukabila.
Ukabila wao.
Yeah.
Wanauliza wewe ni nani?
Aha.
Tunatumia lugha yetu nzuri ya Kiswahili.
Yes.
Na maisha yanaendelea.
Maisha inaendelea. Yeah. So what he's saying, ile the reason kwa ile sababu yenye narudia kwa Kiingereza ni kwa sababu kuna watu ambao wanaweza watch hii na hawajui Kiswahili. So he's saying, I've asked him what he thinks of Tanzanians and he says that Tanzanians are very good people. They do not have tribalism and yet they have over 128 tribes here. They have a very good heart. So far, according to him, Tanzanians are very, very, very good, open people. They see everyone as brother and sister, and I can highly, highly agree with him. So what do you think of Kenyans compared to Tanzanians? Like wa Kenya na wa Tanzania, kuna utofauti kidogo?
Hamuna utofauti kwa sababu sisi kule kwetu,
uh-huh,
wa baba zangu wadogo,
uh-huh,
wapo Kenya, wengine wapo Tanzania.
Okay.
Na sisi kabila letu ni moja.
Ni moja, Wakuria.
Kabila letu na desturi zetu ni moja.
Ni moja.
Hamuna shida yoyote.
Hakuna shida lolote. Lakini Kenya si Wakuria ni wachache sana.
Ukichukulia kulingana na mkoa wa Nyanza, wapo ni wengi.
Okay.
Kwa maana wapo Ntimaro, Makarangu, Kuitembe.
Okay.
Ndani hao wote ni Wakuria.
Uh-huh.
Na sisi huku tupo vijiji vya huku wachache.
Kuna Wakuria huku Tanzania?
Wengi sana.
Lakini
vijiji
20. Lakini Wakuria wenye wako Kenya ni wengi kushinda wenye wako huku?
Hapana, Watanzania wengi wale kule.
Oh.
Lakini asili yetu, uh-huh, ni Kenya.
Ni Kenya. Oh. Okay. Yes, najua asili. So he comes from a tribe in Kenya called Kurias. And Kurias is a very small community, but he says that we also have Kurias who are here in Tanzania, but more Kurias stay here in Tanzania, but they have originated from Kenya. Unajua wa Abasuba?
Eh?
Unajua Abasuba?
Najua wa nini, Kipsigis?
Ehe, Kipsigis.
Aha,
Kipsigis.
Wale nani hao?
Abasuba, unajua Abasuba?
Eh, Abasuba anafajua.
Oh, na Wakisii unawajua?
Aha.
Ehe.
Eh, kule Kericho.
Kericho, Nyamira,
Nairobi.
Yeah.
Nishaenda,
okay.
Eh, Wakikuyu.
Aha.
Eh, watu wazuri. Ila sisi tumepakana na Wakipsigis.
Wakipsigis.
Eh, wakina Uruto.
Yeah.
Rais wa kweli.
Eh.
Kule mwishoni.
Eh.
Eh, ukienda Masai Manyara,
eh,
na Tanzania Serengeti.
Serengeti.
Mbuga zote zimeshikamana.
Zimeshikamana.
Na ukitaka kuvuka hamna sehemu, hamna ukuta. Wanaweka beacon tu unavuka. Imaro Tanzania.
Tanzania.
Hamna shida.
Na okay. Yeah. Okay. So what he's basically saying is that he understands what Kenya is in terms of the tribes that have asked him, and he's also saying like the borderline that we have in Timaru and Serengeti, there's really not like a border. They've just put the beacons of the land to separate Kenya and Tanzania. So if you want to come to Tanzania, you just cross over to Serengeti. So we are going to the next person so that we can hear their opinions concerning Kenyans as a Tanzania. So asante sana, tumeshukuru. Asante sana, tumeshukuru. Hata wewe ubarikiwe zaidi na zaidi na zaidi.
Unaenda kanisani, unaenda msikitini?
Naenda kanisani.
Unaenda kanisani.
So guys, we have another Kenyan. This is Kenyan. He stays here in Tanzania. So we're going to ask him how he thinks of Tanzanians because he's Kenyan, okay? So, unaitwa nani?
William.
He's called William. Unafanya nini Tanzania? I'm asking him what he's doing in Tanzania. Zamkono. So he's in Tanzania for business and he also does like other work. So what do you think is the difference between Tanzanians and Kenyans? What do you think like is the major difference?
Tanzanians and Kenyans?
Yes. Ni nini kuna utofauti kidogo katikati ya Tanzania na wa Kenya?
Okay.
Vile umeongea na wao, vile umeinteract na wao kama watu. Eh, kuna utofauti kati ya wa Kenya na wa Tanzania?
Kwa mbali sana.
Mm-hmm.
Kwa mbali, basi adabu ni wale wale tu.
What he's saying is that there's very little difference between Kenyans and Tanzanians. Just as he had said. And he's saying that human beings are just the same people, so there's literally no difference. So, mbona umechagua kukaa Tanzania na si Kenya? I'm asking him why he chose Tanzania and not Kenya. Kwa nini umechagua kufanya huku biashara na si Kenya? Ulitaka hivyo? Okay. So what he's saying is that he just made a decision to come to Tanzania and do business here and do work here and not Kenya. So will you go back to Kenya ama unataka ukae huku, uishi huku, retire huku? Okay. So lazima. So umekuja tu huku biashara kidogo, biashara alafu utarudi nyumbani baadaye.
Ma plan zangu ni kwamba labda pengine nipungue business, yani business yangu hapa iendelee.
Ikiwezekana
pia kumpiani nianzishe kule niwe na kwa
kote kuwili.
Yeah,
okay. Yeah. Okay. So what he's saying is that he wants a business over here in Tanzania, which he already has, and he also wants to open a business in Kenya, both the same places. So asante sana, tumeshukuru. Yeah, ni vizuri kukujua. Mimi naitwa Ann. I'm a Kenyan YouTuber.
Yeah. I was taking video.
Kituo kinachofuata ni Simbazi. The next stop is to Simbazi B.
So this area seems like that of, you know, buying spare parts of your motor vehicle. We also have this kind of setup in Nairobi. There's a place where you'll go in Nairobi, hey, and my goodness, they sell all kinds of motor vehicle parts. I don't want to go inside. You know, in your agal, you just have to be cautious enough. So guys, I've had to cross the road. There are so many boys there who are just waiting for me to pass there. So I had to cross the road over to this side. So this side of town looks like, not looks like, they sell motor vehicles. Not motor vehicles, but spare parts of motor vehicles. And you hear, you see here, they're saying the railway crossing. So the railway that I was telling you is this over here. That is the railway crossing. Do you think this city is clean? So that's how their railway looks like. Hey, motor vehicles are all over here, just like Kenya. Maybe I can walk over this side to show you this railways, these trains. They look like they are not being used anymore. Ati kupita njia hii kwa asiye ruhusiwa ni marufuku. They are saying that passing by here is not allowed for people here. Marufuku kupita njia hii. And if, the reason why you hear me reading this is because Kiswahili is a national language, not only just in Kenya, but it is also shared across Tanzania, Uganda, across the East African region. So we are able to communicate with each other well. So let's see this old school. You guys pray for me. I do not get caught. But the gate is on. The gate is open. So let's see and then get back. Guys, I am afraid, but so I don't. Why are the doors open? Why are the doors open? So I can get into one of them. Can I? Just pray for me, wherever. If you're watching this right now, pray for me. Why are they open though? Can someone get in? Let's see. So this is how the train is. This is how the train is looking like. In this is where, like, you know, you climb up the stairs over here, and we have other trains over there, and the railway that is up here is what that is being used currently, as you can see. It is very long. It looks good. It looks super, super, super good. But we are in one of the old school trains like this. So one thing I'm impressed is that as much as these trains are open, you cannot, as much as these trains are open, there's no litter. Like, it is super, super, super clean. You can just come. I've asked someone, you can just come and chill. And they have this, these things over here where you can hold. If a lot of the seats are full, you hold them, and they look very, this is very, very good quality. As you can see, they have been used and used and used and used, but it is still very, 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 very good quality. Okay, I was hoping, like, to go on the other side using this door, but probably on the next cabin, but probably I might not. Another sink over here. I'm impressed. It is clean. So I want to come down and go to the other cabin. So let's see. Oh yeah, maybe I could not go to the other cabin. So this is another train over here. So let us just explore it. I'm pretty sure it is basically the same, but let's explore and see what's inside. Is it slightly different? And in your country, where are you watching this from? And do you guys still use the old school trains? So the setup is basically the same. Oh, this is a toilet. See here, it's written toilet. And this, oh, we can open and see. Okay. So this is where the toilet is. So this is where the people were going. So it was not a sit-down toilet. It smells a little bit, but that is it. Let me close it. How was it closed? Okay. Something like that. The setup is the same. These are a little bit more darker because the windows are closed. So we can get to the others and see if they are offering anything different. But if you're watching this, you can tell us in the comment section where you're watching us from. And also tell us, do you have these old school trains in your country? In Kenya, we do have them. A little bit modernized, but almost basically the same setup. So I don't know if these trains, they are being used or not being used. I don't know. They are all just open. So this is one of them. I want to get into one of these that has more windows down. This one has more windows down. So let's see. And these stairs, they are very, very high. Super high. Thank God I'm a tall girl. Okay. So the staff area, what's in here? Okay, this one is not opening. I don't know what's in here. On this other side. So let's see. Let's see. This is a toilet. Cho means toilets. Okay, so they had a down toilet, not a sit up toilet. And then the sink over here. This is definitely an old school train. Do you have this in your country? Or even if you don't have, like you're not using the trains, do you have like such a setup where the trains are just there and they are not being used? Guys, what do you think? And then something else that I've seen, you know, Tanzania is a hot country. Not really hot, but Dar es Salaam, the Dar es Salaam town is close by the Indian Ocean. So they have put these fans over here. You guys can see. They have put these fans at least to ensure that the heat is not too much. And besides that, I'm pretty impressed. The quality of these seats are very good. And from the toilet, you can tell that these trains are very, very, very old. They might even be more than 30 years old, right? How many years old do you think these trains are? So this might be even 30 years old. But the quality of these things, this is so strong. It's not even moving. Same as the seats. Like, we just have a few dents here and there. But you can tell that this is good. I can see over here. Let's see. Let's see what's here. Ah, this is so well maintained, I'm telling you guys. If you just get someone who can this be revamped? Those people who understand the motor vehicle thing. Like how revampation, like how renovating someone renovating something works. Can this be renovated and just work well? Because this is in very, 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 very good, super, super, super good condition. And I would love to know if this can be renovated and work. Here I can see is those where the wires pass, you know, things to control the train. And you can see even the door is, oh my God, the door is even working, man. So organized, I like it. So let's see, this is another toilet. Mm-hmm. Are you telling me that people are going to the toilet and then it goes down like that? Are people going to the toilet and then it goes down like that? You need not tell me in the comment section. Do people go, are the toilets in the trains like this? Oh my God, I'm curious. Are they normally like this? Oh my God, I'm curious. So we have a sink over here. So this is definitely old school. Yeah, so this is one side of the train. This train, this one looks a little bit bigger than that over there. So we are going to explore another one of the cabins on this other end. But please let me know in the comment section if this can be revamped. If this can be revamped, tell us. Or if it cannot be revamped, tell us in the comment section if you have this in your country and they are just sitting somewhere. In agriculture, we used to read that this heavy machinery, when they get old, they are normally not being revamped, like they cannot be revamped. But I'm curious, are you telling me these things cannot be revamped? This definitely looks older, much, much older compared to the other one. And as from this, I had shown you, see how it has eaten life, like it has been used and used and used. And we have these fans over here for air regulation. I think this can be revamped. I'm telling you, I think this can be revamped. If we just get, or it can't be revamped anyway. I really know less things concerning mechanics. I know, even holding a steering wheel. Anyway, I know when that time will come, I will be able to hold a steering wheel. I even don't know. So let us explore one of the toilets of this. Okay, this is closed. Hey, it's too dark. It's because this here is closed. But the setup is almost the same. And the toilet, the sitting part, it is not the sitting part. It is, you have to bend down. Mm-hmm. This other end. Ooh, this other end. Let's see what's here. What's this, guys? This one looks new. This looks new. Nicoline, nipige picha moja. I'm telling my friend Nicoline to wait for me. This looks new. I don't know maybe if they want to use it or not. But I want to get into one of these. Nicoline, nipige picha moja. Oh, this is wood. This is wood. Ooh. Okay. This looks much older. Number one, because of the wood. This wood over here that I have climbed on top. Okay, this maybe looks beyond repair. But these other two, we can definitely repair. Oh, was this first class? Was this a first class train? You see, it has doors. Hala, was this a first class train? Ewo. I think this was a first class train. You people tell me in the comment section. Do you think this was a first class train? You see, it has a door and then inside here a cabin. What is this? What do you think this was on top here? Huh? A sink. Wow. Bed. This looks definitely much, 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 much older. This one is locked. And then on this other end, we have this like material thing. And then this one at least also, I don't know, I think maybe this was first class and then a sink over there. And I think maybe this was where you put your toiletries or something, I don't know. Yeah, so please tell me if you have this in your country. Did you enjoy the tour of the old school trains in the Republic of Tanzania? I just bumped into this and was like, yeah, I can show you this. Let me know in the comment section. And then on the outside, that is how it looks like. That is it, that is it, that is it. Oh my god! So guys, if you enjoyed the tour, let me see if Nicoline is gone. Oh my god, Nicoline is gone. I wanted a picture here. Yeah, so that is the tour of the old school trains in the Republic of Tanzania. If you enjoyed this short tour and this short video, give this video a big thumbs up. Do not forget to subscribe. And I will definitely see you on the next vlog. And remember, in a world where you can be anything, please be the person who ends the meeting.